Hey, it's Carlos Cavallo from datingfire.com and datingadviceguru.com. If you want to create a relationship of love, trust, and connection, you have to know if your man is being faithful. It's also important to see any signs that he might have cheated. If he's thinking of being unfaithful or having an affair, you got to know. And that's what we're talking about today. I'm going to give you real signs that he cheated. Is he having an affair? Let's find out. First off, before you do anything, stick around to the very end because I'm going to give you a tip at the very end of the video. And of course, make sure you do the big three. Number one, like and subscribe to the videos. If you like them, why wouldn't you? Turn on the notifications, that little bell indicator next to the subscribe button. And of course, if you have any questions or you want to suggest a video, leave that in the comment section below. Yeah, some men can stray, and usually not because he's a bad person. He strays because he doesn't know how to navigate his own emotions to avoid the temptations. Sometimes a relationship can be tested, and you don't want to lose a good man to a bad situation. But first, we got to ask a very important question. What do you think is cheating? For many people, cheating is any activity with somebody of the opposite sex. For others, it might need to take a romantic overtone. And for some other women, it might require an emotional attachment or just physical cheating. Whatever your definition might be, you're probably pretty sure you know when a guy has been up to no good. You know what your limits are and you won't let them get out of control. But one thing you need to do up front when you get intimate with a guy is to let him know what you consider acceptable versus not acceptable. If you don't tell him, he can always pull that excuse of, "Well, I didn't know." Yeah, we know that's not a legitimate reason, but you don't want to leave your boundaries in your relationship ambiguous or fuzzy at all. One of the most common problems I notice in relationships is when these boundaries haven't been talked about, mostly because of fear. Now, before we get started here, I want you to be sure that you realize that everything I'm going to point out here about men's behaviors when they're cheating are also true about women in the same situation. It's very tempting to make men out as being the most or the more unfaithful of the two genders and less trustworthy and less reliable. But if we start believing these ideas about men and cheating, you can create really harmful trust issues for yourself. When we ascribe a particular behavior to a whole gender, in this case men, we do run the risk of creating prejudice and mistrust. Just remember that the door swings both ways. Compassion is a better companion than suspicion and fear. Now let's dig into some of these signs. I'll cover as many of them as I can with you here. Sign number one, social media signals. One of the most obvious signals you'll encounter is when you notice something concerning on social media, something that raises your alarms. For example, if you noticed on Facebook that he's getting tagged in someone else's photos more than usual, or he's commenting on some other woman's page, you should keep an eye on that. It's more and more common for people to start flirting through social media, and that's how these kinds of side relationships can often start. So you got to keep your eye on them. Sign number two is your instincts are tingling. Yes, your spidey sense. This one is extremely important. If you find that you have this weird gut feeling that something's going on, that probably means something's going on. Most women discount their feminine instincts these days, and that's a shame because you can trust your gut to give you an alert when something isn't quite right. Get back to trusting yourself. If something just feels a little bit off, you should take a closer look at it. Don't ignore your inner voice of wisdom. When you learn to distrust yourself, it can be very hard to rebuild that relationship again. The next sign is he goes dark for long periods. If your man disappears for long periods of time, more than a day or so, that's an indicator that he's preoccupied. If he's normally the kind of guy that stays in touch and then he disappears all of a sudden, it's an even more important signal to you. A conscientious boyfriend or husband will definitely let you know what's going on if they fall out of touch for a longer than usual period of time. He'll let you know. If he doesn't offer any kind of explanation, you might even want to ask for it before you discover months down the road that he had another girlfriend. The next sign is you're on the defense. One way that a guilty conscience can show itself is when a guy accuses you of cheating when you're obviously not. Sometimes that's his guilty conscience trying to shift the attention and the focus and the blame over. It's also a very effective strategy because when you're on the defensive, you can't be on the offense at the same time. Eventually though, you will smell this one for exactly what it is. Sign number six is some changes in the bedroom. Now, if you're noticing that he's not very interested in the whoopee with you or that your bed has grown a little cold, That's a sign of relationship problems, even him stepping out on you. You might think that if he's cheating, he's going to want less sex with you. However, that's not always true. Sometimes it actually inspires a little bit more interest, so it can go the other way. If he's showing you a lot of new moves in bed or a lot more interest, that might be a sign he's been getting a little bit more inspiration from outside your bedroom. Again, I can't cover every one of the signs today, but if you want to get them all, go on over to datingfire.com and check out the article there. Rush to the bathroom. Yes, if he comes home to you and immediately runs into the bathroom and takes a shower, you might have already figured out why this happened, right? He's trying to cover something up, especially if he avoids contact with you before he gets to the shower. He's trying to wash the scent of another woman off of him. This is one of the first indications that you should watch out for, and if it repeats, there's a good chance that he's cheating. Strange schedule changes is another big sign. If you're noticing a new pattern of activities for him that he never had before that involved him not being home with you or staying out later, you got to check that out. This one falls into the category of watch out for any sudden changes, any changes in his behavior. If he suddenly has a new yoga class he's got to go to or some activity that's difficult for you to check out and verify, it's time for you to verify. Next sign is he's turtling. If he's withdrawing from you, pulling back into his shell, that's a warning sign that he might be cheating or having an affair, especially if he was fairly close to you before this. A sudden change in distance between you and him, especially if you've been dating for more than 6 months, that's a cause for concern. Actually, any kind of sudden change in his behavior should be taken as a warning sign if he hasn't explained what's going on to you. He may not be cheating, but you need to help him open up and explain what is it that's going on, why the change. Don't let it ride just because you don't want to rock the boat. Push him for the sake of your relationship. You'll be glad you did. Next sign is overcompensation. This one's really common too. One of the ways that guilt shows up is in how we treat our partner. If you've ever had an argument where you felt bad about what you said or you knew you were wrong, and then you went out of your way to do something nice to make it up to him, you know what I'm talking about with this one. If he starts buying you a bunch more gifts, if he starts being really nice to you and acting like he's trying to make up with you, even if you haven't had an argument, well, then you should really be wary. If he's feeling guilty, he may even try to make it up to you, and that may be a sign of a guilty conscience. The next sign is he's upgraded his look and his wardrobe. This one's kind of a cliche, but it's still true, and it's one you might not guess if you didn't know what it was. If he changes his look and he starts becoming more concerned about his appearance, he must have somebody that he's trying to impress, especially if he starts to try to lose weight. When he hits the gym pretty hard without a good reason, you know what the good reason is, don't you? Next sign, you start feeling hidden. Another behavior a guy will start to show is when he tries to cover up your presence in his life. Like he might stop tagging you on Facebook and in pictures. He might stop taking you to company parties. He might just generally start hiding you from the world. He may stop posting photos of you two together online and Pinterest or any of those. After all, he doesn't want others to know about you if he's cheating on you. He may even just be setting himself up to find a new relationship. Just remember my rule. Happy couples are happy to be seen together all the time. Here's one that's huge if you got the guts. You ask your friend and they say yes. Here's another ugly truth. Other people can usually see what's going on much clearer than you can in your relationship. If you ask your girlfriend if she thinks your boyfriend is cheating and she says yeah or possibly, you should really take a closer look. The same thing goes for your family. If you ask your mom and she shows concern, you probably have a reason to be concerned too. The next sign is his friends are cheaters. There's no denying the saying, birds of a feather do flock together. If you're aware that your husband or your boyfriend is hanging out with friends who have, let's just say, a less than honest way with their girlfriends, in other words, they run around on them, you're gonna have to either separate him from them, which could get ugly, or you're gonna have to keep a really sharp eye on him. And then you're gonna have to start separating him from them gradually. It's just inevitable. But one way or the other, you have to remember that a man's peer group has the greatest influence over him. He needs friends, but if he's gonna be a reliable man for you, he has to have honorable friends too. The right kind of friends that will help support you as a couple. That's what you need. The next sign is you start smelling his lying. If you're starting to detect that he's telling you more and more lies, you should be concerned that he could be cheating on you. Some of the kinds of lies you might see are he lies about the places he's been, he lies about the people he's been hanging out with, he lies about who he's calling, who he's texting, and so on. Look, nothing is too sacred to lie about when you're in this situation. Sometimes the lies just become addictive. Part of the insane spiral of bad behavior that usually accompanies an affair. Both sides do this. After all, part of the fun of cheating sometimes is this secretive side of it. And then the lying becomes a habit for him that he can't stop. And the last sign here is picking fights. One of the most obvious indicators that he's cheating is when he's trying to pick fights with you. He may even appear obviously trying to break up with you this way, because in some way he is trying to push you away. He's trying to give you enough reason to walk away or at least stay at a distance so that he doesn't have to do the dirty work of breaking up with you or admitting that he was cheating. Now, if you notice that he's starting a lot of fights, call him on it. Ask him why is he doing it, and then watch his body language as he's confronted about his behavior. You'll be able to tell immediately if it's just that he's looking to get out of the relationship or if he's actually cheating. Remember, the best way to keep your man faithful to you is to create a relationship that he would never want to lose. That's really huge. Create the relationship he wouldn't want to walk away from. I call this the preventive maintenance plan for relationships. And it works much better than waiting for a mistake down the road to cause a problem. It's like your health. If you eat well and you exercise now, you'll stay healthy for a long time. You will live longer than you would if you didn't. If you neglect your health, it's unlikely you can ever earn it back again. It never comes back the way it was. So stay ahead of problems and you can have him love you forever. You can have a healthy relationship. Now, what do you do if you think he is cheating? Well, first of all, make sure you know for sure what's going on. You don't want to accuse him wrongly or be in error and risk that kind of embarrassment. Plus, it could also really hurt his trust for you, knowing that you don't trust him. If you feel reasonably certain, 80% higher, you know, or higher than that, that he's seeing another woman, you gotta put your foot down and confront it. The longer you wait, the more damage your relationship will sustain, and the more likely you won't make it through. Everyone in the world is capable of cheating. It's true. Now, if you find yourself saying, "No way, Carlos, no way I would ever cheat," then guess what? You are even more likely to cheat. Why? Because this shows that you have a blind spot in your own behavior that you're covering up with the illusion of resolve. We often do this. The more we allow ourselves to accept it, while cheating is a damaging betrayal, absolutely, we can also realize it's not the end of the world. And guess what? Hold on to your butts here. And not only is cheating kind of common, it can also be prevented. The first step to prevention is awareness. That's what I'm giving you here with all these signs. For you to be aware of him, you've got to know what is he feeling most of the time. Do you know that right now? Do you know what your man is actually feeling about you and the relationship? Because you've got to have your finger on the pulse of your relationship so that you can see things coming before they arrive and you're not blindsided. You're not just blown out of the water like this. You've got to be able to read him like a book. Now, this is something you probably didn't learn from your friends. You probably didn't learn it from your mom, but it is something I can show you. You're lucky you got me here, Carlos, who actually knows what guys are thinking. I can even tell you what he's thinking before he probably thinks it, because you've got to be able to read a man's signals. How do you read his signals? Easy. You got to know how to connect with men and know what they're up to, what's going on in his mind without him telling you. Because as you know, getting a guy to tell you this stuff is next to impossible. So you've got to know how to tell what's going on from the outside to see the signals and the signs that you can understand and predict. There are a ton of things that guys do that tell you exactly where they are in the relationship. Is he ready to commit to you? Do you want to know if he's still interested in you? Do you want to know the reason he's creating distance from you? All this stuff he's telling you right now, but you might not be picking up. He's giving you the signs, but you're not seeing them for what they are. So if you want to get the interpretation, you want to know what's actually happening, I can show you. And I got a great way for you to do it. Go to the little link you see below me here, datingfire.com/HelpMeCarlos. That's datingfire.com/HelpMeCarlos. What I've got there is a really cool little assessment tool I just put up recently, and I think you can get a lot out of this. Go take it. It's like about 15 questions that will actually drill you right down to the core of what's going on in your relationship. If you've got something going on, you need to know what he's thinking. You need to know what's going on and what's stopping you. I call this the relationship roadblock quiz. Go take it now. It's at datingfire.com/HelpMeCarlos. You'll get my free ebook. You'll also get the answers to the questions you've got about your relationship. It's all there and you can get it now. Go on over to datingfire.com/helpmecarlos. And before you run away, make sure you do the big three. Make sure you like and subscribe to the videos. If you stuck around this long, hey, why not? And keep sticking around because I got one more tip for you at the very end. And of course, make sure you turn on the notification, that little bell indication next to the subscribe button, so you know when my next videos come out. And if you have a question or comment, leave that in the comment section below. Hey, this is Carlos Cavallo from datingfire.com. Stick around, I got a little something for you in a minute. As always, live and love with passion. Another one of the huge signs that he might be cheating is when you find yourself in story time. You gotta watch out for him contriving stories with you. Technically, this is another form of lying, but it's a more convoluted part. He'll often create these convoluted stories to explain things to you. Typically, his whereabouts, what he was doing, you know, when he was out with his friends. Yeah, with her. There's a lot of signs that a story is being made up for you. There's too much detail in his story. There's too little detail in his story. He's got weird body language when he's telling you what's going on. He gives you contradictions in the story. His eye motion is all over the place. It's sketchy. Look, if you think he's making up stories, rather than challenge him, you probably should go along with it for now and then watch his behavior closely. And then just do the stuff I teach you in my programs.